Amelia? Amelia? Darren, you're going to be late. Roz! Roz!
Aaron, what is it?
The kids have gone.
Put the peanut butter on the table, Shine. And don't say anything to Dad about the baby. It's a secret, all right?
All right.
Don't think you can handle it.
Would Sarah like the full English breakfast?
Or just the toast and cornflakes?
What have I done to deserve this?
Can't we make our dad a nice surprise once in a while?
You heard from your mum?
Yeah, she came round for a bit last night, didn't she, Shone?
Yeah, she sent her love.
Oh, well, that's great, isn't it?
I know that, Jenny, but they're both gone.
We should be contacting the action group. We should be calling the police.
We don't know, maybe this morning. We're worried sick.
They could be anywhere by now.
But something's happened to them. What if they're in trouble? Yeah, okay. Yeah. I don't know.
We've got to get help.
Jenny says not to.
Well, Darren's my son, not Jenny.
She says if we call the police now, we're as good as putting Amelia back on the plane ourselves.
My child is missing. Anything could have happened to him.
Please just let them be all right.
How can I let Darren get involved in this?
It's not my fault.
A couple of hours, then I'm calling the police.
Good morning, sir.
Hey.
Yeah, good morning to you, Max. Mr. Robson, is it usual for you to encourage this vulgar, attention-seeking behaviour amongst your pupils?
Free speech is a principle which Grange has always sought to encourage amongst its students, Mr. Robson.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. A bit late, all right. All right?
Who do you think they're after?
No, my luck, probably me.
So what's all this then, Matt?
This is part of the protest, part of the logos on my design.
Oh, should be fun talking to the press like ever.
Handling the media is an important part of any protest campaign.
Yeah, that's what I always say.
Better wait a bit.
You don't think the kids could be here, dear, in school?
No. Darren's too smart to risk that. We'll wait and see some of his mates soon. We'll ask them. They'll know.
Yeah, you're right.
Yep.
Seem to be making a habit of this, Mr. Robson.
Well, much as we like the local police, I'd rather we had less reason to see quite so much of each other. Is there any news?
All we have at the moment is guesswork. There's not a shred of evidence against the Hartson boy.
Well, isn't it your job to find some?
What we need is a witness. Now, if you can come up with that, we might at least have somewhere to start.
I'll let you know if we hear anything. I'll bet he's out there right now laughing at us. Jeff, there's no earthly reason to assume it has to be Danny. Why would he want to get himself into even more trouble? It just doesn't make sense. Unless there's something you're not telling me. No, of course not.
Hiya. Where's Darren then?
He said he'd pick me up from my place, but now
Spencer,
not.
Calvin.
We need your help. Darren and Amelia have disappeared.
Please think very hard about where they might be.
Don't you know any other hot contacts in the music business then?
No. Tarquin is the best I can do at the moment. It's just pit bad luck, that's all.
Bad luck? Mate, we've totally blown it. He's never going to take us seriously now, is he?
Got the tape.
All right.
Brilliant.
Yes, I do.
What's on it? Anything I like?
Nothing.
Let's have a look then.
I can't, sorry. Thanks, Arnie.
just like I said, you can't help your feelings, can you?
Oh, no, it's just the whole gay thing. Never really thought about it before.
It doesn't scare you, does it?
No, of course not.
So, for homework, I want you to explore the idea of freedom fighter versus terrorist. How do we reach these definitions and why?
You mean one man's terrorist is another man's freedom fighter, miss?
Exactly. The way we define events throughout history depends on whose side you're on. So, that's 1,500 words by next week, please.
It was really down this morning.
It's all that Shannon sticking her oar in.
Why does it have to be Shannon's fault?
Sorry?
All I'm saying is it might have been Tommy was in the wrong.
I don't believe you just said that.
Look, if Leah went into the room with him upstairs on her own, what did she expect?
Yeah, I mean, she knew Tom really fancied her. Everyone knew.
Well, she's just trying to get back at Tom for telling everyone they did it.
Don't you think you should be over there with Leah, giving her a bit of moral support?
Yeah, we're just saying that, weren't we?
I can't believe it. They'll have the whole school buzzing around them soon, giving them loads of sympathy. I mean, it's not like anyone with two brain cells to rub together will believe a word that Shannon says.
Yeah, but why would Shannon want to make something like that up, though?
For the same reason she's told all those other lies. It's second nature to her. And anyhow, how comes you're so keen to defend her?
I'm not defending her.
Well, it doesn't sound like it.
Mate, if you were going to buy a new mobile phone, couldn't you have at least made it a quiet one?
You've got to surf the web, mate.
Checking out some holiday options.
Short break in the West Indies?
Yeah, you got big plans, have you, mate?
Oh, I might have. What's so funny about that?
What, when you win the lottery?
Yeah, keep buying those tickets, Wayne. You might win another tenner.
Yeah, by the time you're 40.
Such a loser, mate. You're never going to win.
Yeah, well, I already have.
Yeah, tenner.
No, £12,487.36p, actually.
Do you really think Tom could do something like that?
All I'm saying is we went there, we don't actually know what happened.
Well, that's where you're wrong, because I do.
Don't be stupid, Lisa. All you're doing is guessing.
I'm not the one who's being stupid, and I don't have to guess about anything. I know Tom. He'd never do anything
drop
violent.
It, Lisa. It's nothing to do with us.
You think you're so much better than the rest of us, don't you? Well, let me tell you one sad little thing. Nobody likes you. You're just a stuck-up cow.
Wait, leave out! It's not working!
Look, just call it, all right?
Come on, Lisa, come on!
Look, come in!
All right, call it!
Come on, we get...
Calm down! It's not worth it.
Are you happy now?
Not bad. What do you do for an encore? Start a civil war? Hey, I told you my proposition yet.
I don't want to hear it.
Look, all I need is an alibi from when Henkin's collar was sprayed. What is so difficult about that?
The way I see it, you need all the friends you can get at the moment. Know what I mean?
Any news?
Nothing.
Well, thanks for all your ideas, so they've got your help.
Don't worry, Mr. Clark. Amelia's pretty tough. She'll look after Darren.
Thanks.
We'd better be going. We're not really supposed to be here at dinner time.
You go on. I don't want you getting into trouble.
Yes? Darren? It's me. Where are you?
Are you all right? This is all my fault. It's not your job to fix this. Darren, please, just come home.
Darren?
Well, what did he say?
They're all right.
What's that meant to mean?
Well, they have some money and some food and they're safe. They're in back.
Well, you could have got us new gear, man. We could have played in the talent heat tonight.
This is my bank balance we're talking about, mate. Not the band's special piggy bank.
Wait. I chipped in for this ticket,
mate.
So by rights, half of this money should be mine.
Only after we won the tenner, and that don't count.
Yeah, I know. I'm on my 2-week detoxification diet. Boiled rice today. Very cleansing.
Oh, I'm sure you'll feel the benefit.
Well, I was rather hoping you might have a secret stash of bacon sandwiches hidden about your person.
Well, I might have if I hadn't have left them on the kitchen table this morning.
Forget something.
Oh, our hero.
Hi.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
Oh, well, I just thought I'd bring my mother Meals on Wheels.
Careful. I'm not that old.
Well, now that you're here, would you like to come and see my kids' projects?
Yeah, I'd love to. I'll see you later.
Must be nice to be young and in love.
Must be nice to have somebody want to look at your tatty old exercise books.
Just get a two-shot. It's brilliant. So, you actually designed the uniform yourself, did you?
Yes, well, we thought it would be very educational to have some input from the children.
It was all my own work, and you can see it's been trashed by this huge logo.
And it's the sponsors who are insisting on this advertising logo.
Well, hardly insisting, but naturally, we continue to be very grateful to our sponsors.
But at the same time, you do have to draw the line somewhere.
Can I quote you on that?
Certainly not. I think it's about time you were due back in class, don't you?
I haven't finished my interview yet, sir.
Thank you for your interest.
I got right, sir. Freedom of speech. That's censorship. That's what it is. Come on, Max. Yeah.
I've been thinking about Martin.
Oh, yeah?
Well, you know the way he's got special ways of doing things? Like how he puts his stuff in his bag and the way he eats his food.
What's it got to do with you?
Just thought that maybe I could help him.
What makes you think Martin needs any help? Just find the way he is.
No, he isn't. He's dead creepy, isn't he, Shona?
You should have seen him this morning. It was a right laugh.
No, I didn't mean it like that.
Really?
That's not what you said to us at lunch. Is it, Shona?
I didn't say anything.
Look, my brother's fine. He doesn't need you or anyone else sticking your nose in. All right?
I've had a word with our ace reporter friend, and I think we can safely assume there'll be no more articles about Grange Hill or sponsorship in any further issues.
I'd rather not know how you managed that, Mr. Forbes.
The same way you should have managed it. If you want to stamp out insurrection, all you need is a firm hand.
All right.
Someone's having a blowout. Well, I settled that much food since Mr. Robson had a full English during the Ofsted inspection.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind his mobile either.
Nah, I can't be dealing with him, mate. I mean, how are you going to affect an air of mystery around women when they can get you on a blower 24 hours a day?
All right,
man, how's it going?
Yeah. Could any of you lend me a pal for a drink?
Cheers on you, mate.
All right, boys.
All right.
Hey, Talent Leak's just about to start.
Yeah, I know.
I saw this band on TV last night, mate.
Yeah.
And all they had were kazoos.
Well, I'm not giving up on you guys, you know. You guys are no less talented than the people that make it.
Yeah, those guys are rubbish.
Cheers. Yeah, that's what he meant.
Cheers.
Oh, no sign of Love's Young Dream, then?
No, I think they're both long gone.
You don't really mind about Michael and Emily, do you?
Quite honestly, Jane, yes, I do. I mean, Emily's very bright, but, I mean, doesn't she strike you as, well, flighty? And how long is she planning on staying?
Oh, that's rubbish, Margaret. It's not about Emily. You're jealous.
Oh, nonsense.
Oh, come on.
I haven't seen him for 30 years, Jane. I'm entitled to be a bit jealous. Part of me feels like he's still my baby.
Margaret, he came to find you. He's not going to give up on you after all these years.
No one can expect me to put up with this any longer.
Damn you, Hartson.
The heats are starting in a minute. You go on, we'll catch you up.
That boy's getting away with murder.
It's hardly that, Jeff. Maybe if you both try to understand one another.
He asked for it, you know.
What?
Now he's learned what it's like to be bullied.
Oh, Jeff, you didn't. You shouldn't be telling me this, and quite frankly, I don't want to know.
Margaret.
The other day, I was thinking
What's the matter?
I can't remember my words. Why did I ever say I'd do this? I must have been off my head.
Don't worry about your words.
Yeah, well, that's easy for you to say.
Hello. Just wanted to wish you good luck.
She appreciates it and she's glad you're here.
I'll be cheering you on. See you after.
What's she doing here?
I bumped into her yesterday. She said she really wanted to come.
That's all I need.
Oh, come on, trust me. You'll be all right.
It's like everyone's gone mad, this thing about Tom. I can't believe it.
But you can't exactly believe everything that Shannon says, can you?
Something must have happened that night.
I mean, a girl goes into a bedroom with you.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that, you know, you expect it.
Yeah, well, I would.
Shut up!
What?
Would you stop going on and on about it? I'm just not interested.
I used to do country dancing when I was a boy. Perhaps you should consider reintroducing it onto the timetable here.
We have no country dancing teachers going spare just now.
Well, I'd be happy to help out if you needed assistance. Of course, I'd have to brush up my steps a little.
Yeah, that was great. Now, next up, we've got some stand-up comedy with Kelly Bradshaw.
Please!
Kelly?
What's the worst thing that can happen?
The worst thing that can happen is I go out there, throw up, and my life's over.
I was thinking the other day about finding the perfect partner. I mean, admit it, we're all desperate deep down, even though we try to make out we're cool about it. So, I do this compatibility test for this agency. All right, I don't mind admitting, I tick all them boxes. So, the woman looks at me and tells me that I get along well with either an extrovert parrot or a bloke that's got shares in a donut factory.
Full 30. He's usually home by now. I should have looked after him. I should have put him first.
Alan, you have to stop this. You didn't do anything to endanger Darren. You'd never do that.
I know what I did.
Yeah, you tried to stand up for something that you believe in. You know, that's why Darren loves you. That's why I love you. If you want to phone the police now, I'll support you. I'll support you whatever you do.
Leah, we can't talk about this.
We haven't got to do anything.
How could you have told Shannon, of all people, that I attacked you?
How could you have told half the school we had sex?
Because we did. It wasn't a lie. I was happy about it. I wanted people to know.
Well, I wasn't happy about it. You never even stopped to think about me.
I mean, the thing is, most blokes don't understand what a girl really wants. There they are, trying to be romantic, when what we're really after is chips.
I don't get it. Why did you go in there with me?
Because I wanted to be with you.
I knew it. I knew you felt the same.
I'm going to go now.
Leah, wait. Please.
I don't have to talk to you if I don't want to.
Who told you that? It's Shannon. Leah, please. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to.
Made your mind up yet? Well, look, if it's money you want, I can let you have, say, a fiver.
You think that you can get me to lie for you? For a fiver?
What's the matter? Isn't it enough? You usually do it for nothing.
Get someone else to do your dirty work.
So I guess things just weren't meant to be between me and Mr. Donut Man. But in this love game, you've got to be open-minded. You've got to be optimistic, you know what I mean? So last week, I met up with the extrovert parrot. And you know what? We've got a fortnight planned in Tenerife. He's flying, but I'm taking the plane. You've been great. My name's Kelly Bradshaw. Good night.
now, for our final act of the day, we've got something musical, and it's Claire Chaplin.
Urgent. Maybe you can wait until tomorrow. What is it?
In this hospital in town, in a room full of old people. She had cancer. Mum said it had gone right through her. You couldn't see it, except she had these big black bruises and they turned her over. She couldn't even move.
Matt, what's wrong?
You know that talk you did, sir? About that cancer that blokes can get.
Just because your granny got cancer doesn't mean you're likely to suffer any problems whatsoever.
I'm scared, sir. Tell me what to do. I don't know what to do. I did that self-examination. I've got a lump.